其实市场现在所炒的
其实是
主力知道了这样的，
我认为现在我们的房地产的
市场，
观众朋友大家好，欢迎收看本期的古先生说。那么很多人在想要投资的时候都会发现啊，一个项目的选择相对有些困难。那么同样的，在创业者的初期想要融资也觉得有一定的困难。那么今天我们再次请到了 Garrison 和 Mr. Romance 来谈一下，在天使投资人在项目选择的初期他们的一个评判标准和选择逻辑。接下来就一起进入到我们的节目当中来听听他们的言论。
美国是科技全世界科技发展的新趋势和新方向。作为天使投资人，我们应该关注哪些领域？或者说在哪些领域还有我们天使投资的机会
？I think well with Rubicon Venture Capital, we've got some basic investment themes. So we focus on internet, software, and connected hardware. Connected hardware can mean the Internet of Things (IoT) or the Internet of Everything.And for us, we invest in both consumer and enterprise. When you ask the question, what direction is technology heading in? I think that clearly mobile phones, smartphones are like supercomputers that are in our pockets with access to the internet, with GPS trackers, that really does change a lot of industries. And so we see lots of opportunities for disruption that just simply make use of the internet or simply make use of the smartphone.Another big trend is putting little sensors into hardware connected to everything. China is clearly very important with this, and we start getting more intelligence all around us. Little sensors in the enterprise, in the home, in the public domain that enables communication. So big industries like insurance are completely changing when you're able to get information and data.With so much information coming off of all these little devices, we start seeing more and more intelligence in processing this data. So with big data. I think one thing we know for sure is nobody knows. Nobody knows what's going to happen. It's impossible to know. So what you can do is get a methodology of being on top of all these different startups and see what they're working on, and the best ones get funded.And by doing that, you start to have your hand on the pulse and seeing what's going to happen next. So I think the most interesting thing is we don't know what's going to happen next, but we know we're going to be there and we're going to be directly involved with those companies. And that's pretty exciting. The other thing I would say, it's not just about what technologies are going to be developed by entrepreneurs, but basically every single industry, every big industry is getting attacked by startups.And so the big industries need to protect themselves from being disrupted. And the best weapon for them to use, in my opinion, is venture capital and M&A. Invest in companies, buy companies. These are the two things I think we're going to see a lot of. What's very important with the work we're doing here is giving access to the China market for startups from the US, Canada, you know, Europe and everywhere in Israel, and vice versa. We're seeing a lot of innovation here in China.You see a company doing a copycat of Groupon. Once they see Groupon going down, they pivot into food delivery and they start matching the two together. And now it's real value add. So in the past, I think we saw Chinese startups making copycats of Uber, copycats of Groupon, copycats of food delivery. Now it's the Americans that should be copying China. I want to have a VC fund here in China, not just to make money here, but so that we can copythe new innovative ideas coming out of China over in the United States and Europe. So I think things have changed. It's now time for the rest of the world to copy China. And I think that's pretty interesting.
你在投资的过程当中，你是怎么判断一个项目的好坏？就是哪一些投资的关键点，就是可以让你来决定投资这个项目。再一个呢，就是说我们作为中国的天使投资人，在天使投资的过程当中应该注意哪一些细节？
Good question. So at Rubicon Venture Capital, we've got 10 guiding principles. They're sort of like 10 rules of what we look for when we seek to invest. Every VC has their own strategy. Every angel investor has their own strategy. Our strategy is to not be the very first money in, let other angels fund it. Sometimes there's a seed stage VC fund that might have already put money into it. I like to see in the United States at least $1 million of funding already going into it. What's probably more important for me is, for our strategy, is when we're putting money into the startup, we want to see that there's enough cash to give the company an 18-month runway. Even better is if they get a 2-year runway. Runway means that they're spending money every month, and the cash we put in at one time will last them 18 months to 24 months. The number one cause of death for startups is running out of cash. You need cash to pay the people. If you don't pay them, they quit, and sort of the blood leaves the body. So one of the key guiding principles is to make sure there's enough money to get that company through 18 months. This way they get a chance to experiment, to spend some money, to make some products, to try something. And if it's not working great, they have another 6 months or 9 months to raise more money and keep the company going. What you want to see happen is that money goes into the company, they make some progress, they hit a milestone, and based on that progress, they can raise more money at a bigger valuation. Then we see our assets going up and up, kind of like the stock market, kind of like that image. It's going up. So we'll invest at maybe a $10 million valuation or a $5 million. Then we invest again 6 to 9 to 10 to 12 months later at maybe a $50 million valuation. Then we invest again at a $100 million valuation. Then we introduce the deal to other investors we know that are later stage growth investors. And these companies are raising money at a $1 billion valuation. At that point, early investors like us, we might decide to sell some shares. If you and I invested in a company at $5 million, now they're raising money at $1 billion, we might sell 20% of our position, sell 20%, leave the 80% in for the IPO, but get our money back. We've just maybe returned our entire VC fund, and it's now what I call a zero cost investment.
好了，刚才我们听完了 Romans 先生的分享呢，相信大家也是受益匪浅。那么看来眼下的市场依然存在很多的投资机会，把握好当下的投资风口，拥有一个更好的价值衡量的判断标准，相信也会让更多的投资机会呈现于我们的眼前。好了，我们本期的古先生说的节目就是这样了，也非常感谢各位的收看，我们下期节目再会。